All right, guys. I am super excited because Leon Lee has just sent over 9 of their brand new AL120 Unifans. And these are the upgrade to the super duper popular SL120 fans, which kind of broke the computer building world, because what you could do is you could physically daisy chain these fans together, and with just 2 cables coming off of it, you could control their RGB as well as the fan speed. And that is unheard of, because every other fan, each one has like 3 cables. If you have RGB on it, each one has a minimum of like 2 cables popping off of it. So yeah, it was pretty groundbreaking. And the reason why I'm super excited about this is because, well, one, the fact that Leon Lee would send a smaller creator like myself 9 of these fans is like, ooh, I'm super thankful. And the second reason is because this over here is my dream PC build that I built a few months ago. You guys can check out my video breakdown of it over here. But the number one regret I had about this PC were the fans. Speaking of beautiful white light, the fans. They look gorgeous, but they are terrible, terrible to use. The fans that are in here are the Thermaltake Quad Ring RGB fans. And to this day, I still think they're the most beautiful fans on the market, but there are 3 reasons. One of them, which is a total deal breaker, and 2 of them, which are just pure annoying, for why these fans suck. And the first reason is because while they look absolutely gorgeous, half the time, 50% of the time, the fan controller will stop being recognized. I don't know what it is. I did everything. I read forum after forum. I downgraded, upgraded software. I even went out and spent another $90 on these Thermaltake Premium Pro controllers, thinking that would solve the problem. But if you read the fine print, those controllers can only support up to like 4 quad ring fans. And so there was nothing I could do to fix it. So that's the main reason why nobody should buy them. I said that in my last video, and still people bought them and they immediately told me they regretted it. Anyways, the second reason why they're kind of frustrating to use is because while they are gorgeous, they're only gorgeous if they're facing you, meaning the front is the only part that's gorgeous, because if the back is facing you, then you only get 1 out of the 4, hence quad, RGB zones that's facing you. And then the third reason why they're really frustrating is because each cable length on a single one of these fans is like 2 feet long. It's absolutely ridiculously long. So cable management is nuts. On top of that, you need 2 controllers to manage 9 of them, and you have like 3 things to, it's just crazy how bad it is. So introducing the AL120 fans. So like I mentioned before, you could daisy chain these, and with just 2 cables, you could power everything. And that was mind boggling. It was a game changer. But the AL120 step it up even more, because on the SL120 fans, I didn't particularly love the aesthetic, because if I have RGB fans, I want it to blind me as much as possible, like what the quad rings do. The AL120 changes that in that the fan itself has RGB, and then on the eyelids around the corner of the rounded parts of the fan, they're all lit up, they all light up as well. So that is really cool. I like that you can do that, that there's more RGB to the fan, but there's more than that, because not, here's the front, but then take a look at the back. Look how clean that is. You don't see what you see on 99% of fans, which is a tech spec sticker back here, which kind of ruins the aesthetic of the fan. The back of the quads have that same tech spec sticker, but more than that, you don't have the ketchup mustard cables that show up in the back. And instead, you've got this super clean look back here. And then what's beautiful is that the eyelids over here on the back light up just as well. So you're losing maybe about 20% of the RGB if you flip the fan around, but you still get the beautiful aesthetic if it's facing you and it's turned off. The other reason why I appreciate it so much is because look here at 2 of the sides. So on these sides, on this side, and on this side, it connects to, it can be daisy chained, but if you do it on the other 2 sides, you get this beautiful aluminum grill that just looks gorgeous. So when I have these fans sticking out the top, it's gonna have this nice reflector that just looks gorgeous. So yeah, I'm super excited, but it's not just for the RGB and aesthetics. This fan overall is an upgrade compared to the SL120s because it's got bigger fan blades, allowing you for better static pressure and for, you know, more efficient spinach, I guess you call it, so for less noise. I can't wait to flip out these fans and replace it with these. If you buy a single fan, it's $30 US, but if you buy the 3 pack here, I believe it's $100 US, and it comes with a fan controller. And this is kind of the game changer as well. Remember how on the Thermaltake, I told you, I don't need that one right now. The Thermaltake requires 2 controllers to control 9 of these. A single controller can control up to 16 fans. It can do four groups of four fans. I don't know who needs that many fans unless you're Linus Tech Tips, but yeah, for me, I have three groups of three, so I only need one controller to control all of it. So yeah, it's oh man, I'm super excited to do this. I'll talk about lessons learned after I switch everything out, and I'll show you guys the cable manager difference as well. Real quick, I wanna show you guys how easy this is to connect and disconnect. First of all, don't be like me. Make sure you check which side you're on, because I actually had, you know, the front of one and the back of other, and got it stuck for a little bit, so I had to disconnect that. But it's super duper easy. Just make sure again that they're facing the right way, and then you just go ahead and pop it into the hole, and you slide it up, and there you go. This is what I meant by you just get a panel of fans connected together. And if you need to disconnect, just take one and then just slide it the opposite way, and that's it. And what's cool is you notice that there are no cables here, because the cable is also an additional connector. This is so sweet. This way, like, you can configure your fans the way you want first before having to screw everything in and then realizing you did it wrong. So yeah, it's, you just get this, and this has the two cables that I was talking about per set of fans that you can connect, and it just connects on just like this. So let me just do that real quick. So I don't know exactly the way I want it, but just for the sake of the video, you put it on and then you slide it up. Yep, there you go. And it's on, and that's it. Like, this is one, holy crap, I'm super excited. This is one set of fans. Just these cables, that's, oh my God. One con that I just realized is that this fan connector, the thing that connects to the hub, you can't switch sides, so it can only be on one side. And the reason why that sucks is because I need the top to be exhaust, right? And I have more exits on the top right of the case than I do on the left side. But if I have it set so that the cable's on the right side, well, look, it's out in the front, and so then everybody could see it. So if I put it this way, everyone would see those cables. But the thing is, if I turn it this way, while the cables are now hidden in the back, if you look at my case, there's not a lot of hiding spots back here. So that kind of stinks that I can't change. I wish I could reorient it so it could sit on this side, but I don't think I can. All right, so I just finished building it. I can tell you guys that in the back here, I didn't cable manage. I'll show you a picture. The difference is night and day, and I didn't cable manage so that you guys could see the difference between when you have nine of these giant cable things plus a gajillion other things plus two fan hubs versus the super clean Leon Lee setup. Two things that I noticed while I was building. First is that the aluminum front is super nice, but it's a double-edged sword because it's impossible not to get your fingerprints all over it, and they really do show up. So either use gloves or have a microfiber cloth to clean that with. And the second thing is that having that big panel of fans with a couple cables can be really nice, but it can also be a little bit annoying if you have tight spaces. Because let's, like, here on the side fans that I have over here, it would have been easier for me to do one fan at a time, but having all three and try to turn the corner was a little bit hard. I kept hitting the glass, so I had to take the glass panel off. And you can't really put individual fans and then connect it in the case, because that can be really frustrating too. So something is to keep in mind. All right, so I'm gonna hop on a computer, I'm gonna mess with some of the settings, tell you guys my findings, and we'll also do some sound tests as well. All right, I'll be back in a minute. So after some testing, the Elconnect 2 app is really nice to use. I love that everything is found on just a single page. No clicking back and forth to change settings, change LEDs, nothing like that. Everything is controllable on a single page, and you can see the status, the RPM, and everything on, again, a single page. So big thumbs up, and it's easy to use. Some really good things about these fans. Two things is that the LEDs are really, really nice. So look at the white setting on these fans. Look how bright and white they are. Sometimes on cheaper LEDs and cheaper LED fans, oftentimes they will not have a dedicated WRGB or W LED light. And so what happens is if you try to set it to white, you often get this like red slash dull white color. And so exhibit A is, look at these Leon Lee Strimmer whites. I don't know if the camera picks it up, but look how dull and red they look compared to the fan whites and even the RAM whites. In addition to that, when you change it to the color mode and you set it on rainbow, sometimes when you set that transition speed to really slow, you will see a really harsh cutover from color to color, but these LEDs are one of the best I've seen in terms of like how smoothly it transitions from color to color, which testifies, I think, to how many LEDs they put into these fans. Okay, they're not perfect though. They have two issues that I found so far. One of them is pretty major, the other one is a little bit more minor. The major one is that if I set these fans to PWM mode in the Elconnect 2 app, it doesn't work for me. It spins them up to 1800, 1900 RPM, which is their max speed, and it will not come down. It will not work. So PWM basically means that you can control the fan speeds based on the internal temperature of the components. It's not working here. Now, I've read through this a lot. It turns out that this has been a problem even with the SL fans. So it's been a problem for over a year now. And a lot of people said, go into your BIOS and change it from DC control, which is voltage, to PWM. And I did that and it didn't work for me. Nothing I did worked. So yeah, at this point, nothing works. There is a relatively easy and harmless fix though, and that is to buy yourself a fan controller, or if you have enough headers, fan headers on your motherboard, you can just connect them there too, because the way these fans work is that every set of fans will have one connector, and off of that connector are two cables. One of the cables will, I think, control the RGB, and then the other cable is a simple 4-pin PWM fan cable. And the way you set it up is that you've got all those PWM fan cables and the RGB cables going into Leon Lee's controller. Well, if you put the RGB lights into the Leon Lee provided controller, but then take those fan cables and plug them into a fan controller or plug them directly into your motherboard's fan headers, well, then the motherboard will see the fans being connected directly to the motherboard, and then you can change the PWM using whatever software you want. You don't have to use Leon Lee software. And so yeah, you would control RGB through Leon Lee software and then PWM through whatever software you want. Some people have just said, you know what, I'm totally fine with setting them to about like 1000 to, if they're on a pump, maybe up to like 1300 RPM, because it's relatively quiet at that point. The second thing, and it's not a huge con, but it would kind of bother your guys' preferences, it's that these fans don't have the kind of LED control that you would find on even cheaper LED strips, like $20 strips off of Amazon. And the two big things it doesn't have is, one, it doesn't have like voice or sound activation. So sometimes, or a lot of these fans have the ability that, you know, when you're playing a game and you start firing a gun, your PC will pulse, the colors will pulse at you. Or if you're playing music, every time, you know, the bass hits, the colors will flash at you. These lights don't have that ability, at least not that I'm aware of. And then the second thing that it doesn't have is that they have some pretty cool presets, and one of them is like, it's got a chasing mode. I forget what it's called, something runway. I'll write it here in the bottom. But the way it works is like the lights will kind of play like tag. So that first light will hit, then the second one will go, and then the third one will go, and it'll travel up and down your motherboard. But the thing is, you can't control the orientation of how those lights light up. So in my case, what I've got going is that the bottoms will light up, and then it'll climb here, and then when it gets to the top, it'll start from that side and come over. And I was like, oh, I wonder if I can reverse that, because then it'll go nice and smoothly up the motherboard, or up the computer. But you can't. The only way that you can change that direction is by physically removing this fan set and turning it around. That's the only way that at least I found that you can do that. So yeah, you don't have those kinds of fine-tuned controls with the LEDs that I would like to see. When it comes to noise levels, this is what it sounds like at various different RPMs. So for $100 US for a 3-pack with the controller, or $30 for just the fan, are these fans worth it? I'm gonna say 1000% yes. And there are three reasons why. One is because you get a super premium feeling looking fan. I would say arguably the best looking fan on the market right now. Without the LEDs. With the LEDs, you might have some better looking fans, but without the LEDs on, by far the best looking fan. But then you add on top of that super premium RGBW LEDs, and then you add on top of that the innovation of having up to a 4-stack of fans with only 2 cables coming off of it is just mind-blowing in terms of cable management and airflow inside of a case. So yeah, 1000% yes. If anybody asked me, what is your go-to fan, RGB fan, I'm gonna say it's these. It's the AL120s, and that's not exaggeration. The PWM thing is really unfortunate. I hope Leon Lee fixes it or does something soon, but the fix to it thankfully is non-intrusive and it's relatively cheap at about $8 to $15. But yeah, I do hope Leon Lee will fix it. But that's gonna be it for this one, guys. I think I've answered everything or talked about everything regarding these fans. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. If you guys comment or give this video a thumbs up, it really helps push it out to the algorithm. So please just give it a thumbs up or say cool, you know, whatever you want. All right, guys, that's gonna do it for this one. If you wanna check out my other videos on PC builds or build breakdowns or my chair reviews, you can check it out all over here. And until next time, guys, stay safe. And as always, stay honest.